We all love to indulge in a little chocolate every once in a while, but if you've ever thought making your own chocolate would be too challenging, well, think again, because here to help us create our very own sweet treat is author Hallie Baker. I'll tell you what, you couldn't have a more perfect name to go with your occupation unless your last name was chocolate.
Well, you're right. Baker is really my name, too. I didn't change it when I got married, so.
That's excellent. Yeah. I know, I'm smelling the chocolate. People are seeing chocolate on their screen right now. Can we just jump right in?
Yeah.
We have a simple, easy recipe that people can make at home.
Definitely. So what we're doing is we're making chocolate bark, which entails pouring tempered chocolate out onto a parchment paper so it doesn't stick once it's set.
Mm-hmm.
And we want to
kind of smooth it out a little
Spread it in a fairly uniform thickness.
As you smooth that out, you mentioned it's tempered chocolate.
That's not correct. Technically
melted. How do they differ?
Well, melted chocolate is just chocolate that's liquid, but mm-hmm. tempered chocolate has been heated up and then cooled back down so that it will set up in actual, like, room temperature.
Huh.
And the way you do it is heating up chocolate and then adding cold chocolate to seed it. That's the term, is seeding your chocolate. Now that we have a consistent sort of thickness,
yep.
we're going to sprinkle some different things on. I think we should maybe start with the one that...
You mentioned that this is for kids.
Yeah.
But this
is
a bowl of some of my favorite candies. It's like gummy bears and Swedish fish and jelly beans. And so we can sprinkle those right on.
Yeah, and I think if we do them in a stripe,
okay.
then we can actually get a couple other things on there.
Okay, so I'll do this.
Yeah, maybe and you can just sprinkle like crazy, too.
Okay.
So you don't have to be all perfect.
Now, I know you're giving some really helpful tips for folks at home, and they can actually find them in the book that you wrote.
That's right. Making chocolate at home is completely doable. It's not a scary thing. It shouldn't be a scary thing. This is not brain surgery, people.
You brought the book with you. It's called Turtle Truffle Bark. So I'm assuming it's a lot more than just the bark.
Yeah.
Truffle is in the name.
Yeah, so what we do is we start off with bark because it's the most simple way to get your hands on chocolate.
Nice.
And then we move on to turtles, where we learn how to make caramel as well. And
wow.
then in the end, we do truffles, because truffles are definitely the hardest thing. They take time, they take days, they take a little finesse. So
mm-hmm.
you would really know how to temper your chocolate by the time you got to your truffles.
I like that you take it in levels. If you start here, everyone can handle the bark.
Right.
And then work your way up.
Because it can be really intimidating. I mean, a lot of chefs that are pretty accomplished in their homes
mm-hmm.
sort of stop when it comes to chocolate. There's like an intimidation factor that's
yeah.
a little too high.
You just buy your own chocolate
right.
a lot of
but
the
but this is so doable. It's
Good.
so doable.
Let's talk about some of the other little sweet treats that you've brought along with
sure.
us. And you have some right out here.
These are truffles. There's, you know, a traditional truffle rolled in cocoa
mm-hmm.
and then rolled in fun sprinkly bits that are pretty. And these are enrobed in chocolate, which is like the most complicated recipe in the book. But it's dark chocolate and raspberry, which is sort of the most
Yum.
Perfect thing.
And this
that
is
a pistachio turtle, and you should definitely eat that.
Okay, I'm going to take a bite out of this, but we're not done because there's an entire
there's
box of chocolate
so
chocolates
many
here.
More.
Now, where can people find your book and your chocolates?
Amazon, Barnes & Noble, IndieBound.
Oh my God.
I think that's pretty much it.
I need to sit down.
Yeah, well, you can anytime, but, you know, I think we're right here, right now, so just keep eating and
okay.
keep your balance.
I'm gonna start shoving more and more chocolates in my mouth, but before I do, I have to tell you that if you want to learn how to make these recipes yourself and try your own chocolates at home, you can find everything in Hallie's book, Turtle Truffle Bark. It's available now.